Okay, so for today's video, we're going to take a quick look at ordering decimals from smallest to largest. So a simple thing we can do when we're ordering decimals is to make sure that we've got all the numbers to the same amount of decimal places. So if we take a look at these numbers here, we can see we've got a mix of numbers to 1, 2 and 3 decimal places. So for this question, we're going to put them all to 3 decimal places. So I can write this first one as 0.530, we just stick a 0 on the end. The next one along is already to 3 decimal places. We've then got the 0.5, so for 3 decimal places, I'm going to stick another 2 zeros on the end. We've then got 0.58, so stick a 0 on the end of that one. And the final number is already to 3 decimal places. So now all we need to do is go along and compare each digit at a time. So as we can see, for each number, we've got a 0 for the first digit for all of them. So then moving on to the second digit, again, we have a 5 for all of them. So now we're going to be comparing the third digit. So comparing the third digits for each number, we've got a 3, a 2, a 0, an 8, and a 5. So it's actually going to be our 0. It's going to be this 0.500. However, I'm only going to write down what I was given, so that's 0.5. Okay, again, because we know the first two digits are 0 and 5, we're going to be comparing the third digit. So the third digits now are 3, 2, 8, and 5. So it's this 2, it's this 0.525. So that's going to be our second number, so 0.525. Okay, for our next number, comparing the third digit again, we've got 3, 8, and 5. So it's going to be the 3, so it's going to be this 0.530. So all we're going to write down is 0.53. And then the third digit again, we've got an 8 or a 5. So it's going to be the 5, it's going to be the 0.559. So I'll write that down next. And then we're left with our 0.580. So all we write down is what we were given. So that would just be 0.58. So that's just a nice easy method we can use to order our decimals. So to finish off, I've just got a few more examples to have a look at. Feel free to pause the video here and have a go at these. And we'll go through the solutions in just a few seconds. Okay, for this first example, we're going to do just like we did before. Make sure they're all to the same amount of decimal places. So we can see the most amount of decimal places we go to is actually 3, so we're going to do that for each one. So this first one we've got 5.07, so we can put a 0 on the end of there. We've then got 5.03, we can stick a 0 on the end of there. We've got 5.743, which is fine. We've got 5.5, so I'm going to put 2 zeros on the end of this one. And then our final one is also okay, 5.801. So looking at the first digit for all of these, they're all going to be 5. Then we move on to the second digit. So we've got 00758. So we've got 2 zeros now, so we're going to focus on these first two numbers we were given. So the second digit was both 0, so we're going to look at the third digit along. So for the first one it was a 7, for the second one it was a 3. So it's going to be this one here to begin with, our 5.030. So we're just going to write what we were originally given, which is 5.03. Okay, once we've got that one, we know the second one is going to be this one we were just looking at because the second digit was 0, which is smaller than all the other ones. So now we've got 5.070, so that would just be 5.07. Okay, now looking at the others again, the first digit's 5, second digit we're going to compare again. So we've got a 7, a 5, and an 8, so it's going to be the 5. So we've got this 5.500. So again, we just wrote what we were initially given, which was 5.5. Comparing the second digits again, we've got a 7, then an 8, so it's going to be this 7. So we've got 5.743. And then we've got right at the end our 5.801. Okay, and for this final question, we're going to do exactly the same thing. The most amount of decimal places we go to in this question is actually 3, so we're going to do that for all of them. So this first number we can write as 3.900. We've then got 3.870. We've then got 3.873, which is fine. We've then got 3.800, and finally 3.790. So comparing the first digit, that's 3 for all of them. So we move over to the second digit. We've got 9, 8, 8, 8, and 7. So it's going to be this 7 right on the end. We've got 3.790. So we're just going to write what we were given originally, which was 3.79. Okay, comparing them again. We know the first digit's 3, so second digit, we've got 9888. So it's out of these three here, out of the 888. So we move along to the third digit, where we've got a 7, and then a 0. So it's actually going to be this one here, 3.800. which we know we're just going to write as what we were originally given, which is 3.8. So now that we've got that one, we're looking at these two here now with the 8 as the second digit, the 7 as the third digit. So now we've actually got to move over to the fourth digit. Well, the fourth digit in the first one is 0, and then the second one is 3. So the smallest one is actually this one here. So that would be our third answer. So it would be 3.870. So we would just write what we were given, which was 3.87. And then our final one of our 8s was this one in the middle, our 3.873. So that would be our fourth solution. That's what we were given originally, so it would be 3.873. And then finally, all we've got left is our 3.900, which we were given just 3.9. And that would be the final solution to that one. So that's it for today's video. I hope you found it useful. If you did, please feel free to leave a like and consider subscribing. If there are any topics at all that you'd like me to go through next, then please just let me know down in the comments. And I'll try to make some videos on those topics as soon as possible. So thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.